Mechanical ventilation is a modern medical procedure used to assist or replace spontaneous breathing and can be divided into two main categories, positive and negative pressure ventilation. Both methods provide breathing support, yet their mechanisms of action differ fundamentally, each with its unique implications and applications. This quick video will provide an overview of this topic and explain the differences between the two. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. First, let's talk about positive pressure ventilation, which is the most commonly used form in modern medical practice. As its name suggests, it uses positive pressure to push air into the lungs during the inspiratory phase of breathing. Some of the most common types include CPAP, which is used mainly for obstructive sleep apnea and maintains a continuous level of pressure. BiPAP, which is used for conditions like COPD and sleep apnea, and it provides different pressure levels for inhalation and exhalation. Invasive mechanical ventilation, which is used in severe cases, and it delivers air through an endotracheal tube. And high-frequency oscillatory ventilation, which is used mainly in neonates and delivers tiny volumes at high frequencies. Advantages of positive pressure ventilation include flexible control over respiration parameters and applicability in both invasive and non-invasive forms. Disadvantages include the risk of barotrauma, ventilator-associated pneumonia, and negative effects on cardiac output due to increased intrathoracic pressure. Now let's talk about negative pressure ventilation. This older, less common technique involves enclosing the patient's body in an airtight chamber and reducing the pressure around the chest to create a vacuum that leads to inhalation. Some of the most common types include the iron lung, which covers the whole body except the head, and it historically was used during the polio epidemics, and a chest cuirass, which covers only the chest and abdomen and is easier to use but requires a tight seal. Some advantages of negative pressure ventilation include enabling spontaneous breathing and maintaining natural physiological responses, thereby promoting better circulation. Some disadvantages are its ineffectiveness in cases with stiff or non-compliant lungs and its impracticability for long-term management outside of the hospital. While positive pressure ventilation is more commonly used due to its versatility and immediate relief in respiratory conditions, negative pressure ventilation remains valuable for specific cases such as neuromuscular diseases. Both have unique advantages and limitations that clinicians should carefully weigh based on individual patient needs, comfort, and underlying medical conditions. Therefore, a thorough understanding of both types is essential for optimizing patient care in various clinical scenarios. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.